It's H Patrick Drive. That is Patrick with a P.
Oh, that's what you're
saying. Yeah, I know what you thought. Just wash your mouth out. Don't be so cheeky.
Is he not here?
Oh, Den!
The night Angie went, I tried to talk it through with her, but she shut up with me like a clam.
It's because it was too soon. She was in shock that she needs you, lady.
Well, when she wants me, she knows where she can find me.
No, she won't come. You don't know what she's like. She's really upset. Look, she's at the flat now. It's a perfect opportunity. Go on.
Look, I'm no good at this sort of thing.
You're a dad.
I haven't got time to talk. I've got to get to work in 10 minutes. And I don't want to talk either, not after she ignored me like she did. That's what I can't get over. The way she came here, ruined my party, and then totally ignored me. And then I read this. And she's got the nerve to say, why don't I join her in Spain? I mean, what does she think I am?
All right.
It's pathetic, a middle-aged woman falling in love.
Look, it's no good standing there shouting at me. Let's just go in the other room and sit down, shall we?
Look, I can't. As soon as Michelle gets over here, takes over Vicky, I've got to get to work.
All right, after work. Can I see you then?
No, I can't, because then I've got Oscabs. I've got no time at all. God, I was stuck by her through everything. In and out of hotels, in and out of the Dagmar, ear hospital, drunk, sober, and that's what thanks I get, a great big kick in the teeth.
All right, darling. It's no good sitting there torturing yourself. Now, what time do you finish Oscabs?
8.
All right, I'll get Frank to stand in for me. We'll go upstairs, we'll have something to eat, and we'll sit down and talk about this thing sensibly. Look, I can't have you going around throwing great big wobblers all over the place. Just be there as soon after 8 o'clock as you can, because I've got a business meeting later on in the evening, right? Oh, what do you fancy? Chinese, Indian, fish and chips? I'm not going to slave over hot stove, darling, all right? I'll see you there. Ta-da. Come on, dog. 20 enough?
Yeah.
Right, now, I'll get the wine. You do the menu. You buy the food, you cook it, and you lay the tables. You got that?
Yeah, no trouble, yeah.
I want the whole thing ready and you off the premises by 8 o'clock.
Pat,
yeah?
I'm having a very intimate dinner party tonight, me and Sharon. Now, what do you reckon she'd like?
Well, candles, nice tablecloth, vase of flowers.
Candles.
Then just leave it to me, okay? Is this going to be enough to cover my wages as well?
Daylight robbery.
Here, it's worth it. After what she's been through, she needs something to make a fuss of her.
Well, go on, Fanny Craddock, that's all you're getting up it.
Then, call to Shell, she's in a terrible state.
Can I knock off 10 minutes early and you've got to be somewhere by 8?
Oh,
look,
it.
I can't stop, Duncan.
Look, Shannon, I know how upset you are.
Look, please, I've got to go and wait for you.
Look, we're meeting tonight, then. We can meet tonight. I'll get us a takeaway. How about that? Look, Shannon, you've got to talk. You just bottle it.
Okay, so I'm bottling everything up.
Look, I'll pick you up at the flat.
Women, eh, Duncan?
Sorry, because she's a woman, Alice, because of what's happened to her.
What has happened to her, eh? I'll tell you what's happened to her. Angie's mucked her up. And what's Angie, Shannon, woman?
Women, mate, I'm surrounded by them and all. I've got Mum, who wants to be chauvin, here, there and everywhere at a moment's notice. Kathy going on about she when she wants to be at home. I tell you, mate, my life's in a right mess at the moment, and my own life ain't all that clever. I don't know what she's up to.
She's working, isn't she, Pete?
Yeah, and I don't like it. Give me a takeaway.
Sure. It's funny thing, hearing you say that kind of thing. Maybe we ought to swap wives. I'm practically begging she to come and work here.
Well, she's here most days, isn't she?
No, not since she's had the baby. She's shown no interest in this place, none whatsoever.
Well, you just have to employ somebody else, won't you, mate?
Employment? I can't afford it, mate.
Oh, yes, you can. What about the £4,000 you won on the horses, eh? Use that.
Oh, it's gone, isn't it? When? Went on the horses. And if you breathe a word to Sue, I'll kill you.
Rick's gone, I've got to let the laundrette. Miss Grassy Dub, you just have to be understanding for once. Here, Pat.
Mm-hmm.
I've had a letter from Charlie.
How lovely, Doc.
Yes, he said he's coming down from Liverpool as soon as he can. He simply loves the idea of holiday. Be like a second honeymoon, he says.
Oh, yeah? Where'd you have your first?
Oh, well, we didn't know, but Pat, while I'm here, could you lend me some money?
No.
Oh, you see, Charlie needs his train fare.
I'm sorry, Dot.
Donna?
And that's definite, is it? So what's in it for me? Well, plus perks. Well, I don't think it's brilliant, no. But if you say so, I'll give it some thought. Well, as soon as you put it like that, I won't give it any thought at all. The answer's yes.
Why, what is this, a mother's meeting?
Oh,
I don't open till 10:30. It's now 9 o'clock. Out.
Yeah, but Charlie's written to me.
I couldn't care less if the Pope himself has written to you. My licensing hours remain the same. Out.
Oh, my God.
Poor man is in shock, because Angie, he don't know what he's saying.
Could be, but I think you better go just the same, Doc.
Yeah. What do you think he'll do now?
I don't know.
Well, I mean, it were Angie what wanted to go, not him. I've heard he'll stay on now she's gone.
Not out.
Look, Dan. Please. Sharon's really upset.
Oh, her mother's run off with a fella and she's upset. Oh, you surprised me.
Look, I didn't mean it like
Look,
that.
Look, there are a lot of things in this world that upset us, Duncan, all right? And it doesn't make any difference if you go to church 10 times a day to get into his good books. It's not going to help. There's still going to be suffering. And what I said to Dot applies to you. We're not open yet. Out.
Any news of Angie yet?
I don't suppose there will be for a little while.
I can just see her running a bar in Spain. It's perfect for her. She'll do the job marvellously.
Yeah, I dare say she will.
No doubt about it. She's an ace barmaid, that I do know. She ran this place like clockwork.
Yeah.
Well, so do you, of course. You're a damn sight better looking.
Thank you. What
was it? Oh, smile. Cheer up. What's the matter?
Well,
family problems again?
Yeah, well, it's
only
lovely.
They're
just so upset at the moment.
Cheers, you two. I'll see you later,
all right? See you, Simon.
Oh, Simon, before you go, take a picture, will you? Me and Kathy behind the bar.
Oh, no, I ain't had my photograph taken.
Yeah, look through there. Press that.
You took one of me and Andrew the other day. I don't want it taken again.
Right, ready?
Oh, look, I
don't... Here we are. Behind the bar in Warford's leading public house. I made him send this one down to the Gazette. Smile. Hello. Oh, what's your Pete?
I've got my heart set on this place, Frank. You're so right, you and me here. I don't know what I'd do if it fell out of our grasp now. I mean, can't you ask him? Just ask him straight out.
All right, babe, I'll ask him. But listen, if we do get this place...
Seems a bigger if than ever now.
If we get this place, it ain't going to be like this, is it? It's going to be cheerful, cheerful and happy. Everybody friendly, yeah?
I hope so.
Come on, Donna, this is a waste of an evening.
I'm working.
I'm going to ask you to knock off early.
I'd like to.
They won't mind, they're not exactly busy, are they?
You are mighty impatient.
Terrible news about Angie, Dennis. Must come as a terrible shock to you.
Yeah, I'm devastated.
Yeah, there was just one other thing.
Yes.
There's a rumour flying around, Wolf, that you're going to stay on at the vicar after all.
Is there really? Well.
Yeah, well, I want to know if it's true or not, because I'm going to say this just once more. I want you out of Walford.
And I'm going to say it once more. I'm sick to death of you coming round here with a face like a cup of cold sick, telling me what I can and can't do.
So you're not going to tell me your plans then, are you?
No.
Then, Frank's here.
And whatever they are, you'd be the least of my considerations.
Ah, oh, Sarge, can you take over from me now?
Yeah.
Listen, I want your advice, mate. It's Sharon, really. Trouble is, well, you're a father, you brought up a couple of teenage kids on your own, and to be quite honest, I'm a bit out of my depth. I mean, what would you do in my shoes?
What the best
trouble is, you see, I've got to make it up to what with Angie going off and not being around. What I really want to know is what makes a good father.
Well, I think
is it holidays,
you...
monies, clothes, records?
No, nothing like that. Then give her time.
Time?
Yeah, time to listen, time to talk. And it's as simple as that. But except you're lame if you're moving out of Walford.
If? Well, I may not. Or I may stay, Frank, but please, don't quote me on that, OK? Look, thanks for your eyes. That's just what I needed. Thanks very much.
But...
What did he say?
I wish I knew.
Avocado and prawns. You got that?
Yeah, I've got it, yeah.
Over here in your oven, set on low is your chilli, OK? Now in the pan, you've got the water and the rice. And you remember I had to cook that? You remember I told you?
Yeah, I've
got
that, yeah,
right.
Fine, yeah.
Over here, you've got your salad for going with your chilli and your strawberries. Your cream's in the fridge, all right?
Yeah, great. Lovely.
Oh!
Well, Pat, what do you reckon? All my own work.
Well done. Well, why don't you go and put on a jacket and tie? Look decent for your daughter, eh?
Yeah, go on then. Dress up. Go to the old log.
All right, I'll go and commune with my wardrobe, if Angie's left me one.
Oh, Den, before you go, what... Has he said anything to you?
What about?
His plans.
No?
Can't, Linda, I can't. Look, I've got staffing problems, darling. Look, I'm not going to be able to make it till much later. Well, you can come here. Well, yes, great, yeah. Yeah, come in, that's fine. Back way, all right. All right, darling, see you then. Bye. Hey. Don't give us a smile. Oh, come on, darling, sit down. I'll pour you a glass of wine. That'll cheer you up. Here we go, darling. Wine, avocado pear, prawn, mayonnaise, hey? Can't get better than that, can you? That's what you need inside you, darling, something decent to eat.
Look, Dad, I don't know how to say this. I mean, it's all very nice and I am touched, but I can't eat.
Oh, come on, after all the trouble I've taken...
Dad, look, I don't want it. Come off it, Pat cooked it, didn't she?
No, she didn't. Ian did. Yeah, that's better, isn't it?
Look, Dad, I'm sorry about this morning and I'm sorry about the meal. It's just I really don't want it.
Do you want to talk?
Oh, don't know. You know, I've read and I've reread her letter. I've thought every thought there is to think. I just don't know what there is to talk about. The thing is, Dad, I don't believe she means it. I'm sure she still loves you.
No, darling, you heard her. She loves Sonny.
No, Dad, she loves you. She always will. That'll never change. You've got to believe me. I know, Dad, because I've lived with her.
Look, if you're worried about my feelings, don't. Because I've got none where your mother's concerned.
That's the other thing that gets me. She was so mean to you the way she did it. Sending you off around the countryside, looking at pubs, talking of your new life together, and she meant none of it. She was too busy making plans with him. She conned you, Dad.
I knew about it all along.
What?
Ree told me ages ago what they were up to.
Why didn't you try to stop her? Why did you let her do it?
Because when someone thinks they're in love with someone else, there's not a lot you can do about it.
Dad, she's not in love. It's a ploy. It's another one of her schemes to get you back.
No.
She's always doing this.
Darling, this time it's for real. And you got to believe it. Look, if you want to go and live with her, fine. I'll understand. But there is no way that she's ever coming back to Walford.
Look, before Dad, right, I always tried not to take sides. Well, obviously things have changed now, and I just want you to know that I'm on your side now, 100%.
Right.
And if you want me to come back here and live with you, I will.
Oh, don't be daft.
But, Dad, look, I'm worried about you. What are you going to do, eh? You've got no wife, you've got no me, you're all alone.
I've got Rowley.
Look, I'm serious. And soon you'll have nowhere to live either. Seems to me all your plans have gone up the spout.
Look, if we don't tuck into this grub pretty soon, Ian's going to get the right hump, all right? I'll tell you about my plans later. Just dig your spoon in, will you?
Dad.
Eat.
And the other thing I feel angry with Mum about? Duncan. All that stuff trying to get me to marry him. She's just trying to get me off her hands so she could skip off with a clear conscience. She never stopped to think if we were suited or not.
And are you?
Yeah.
Oh, don't tell me his halo's slipping.
Of course not. Look, Dad, I feel a lot better now we've talked. Thanks.
Anytime, Princess. Anytime.
You know, I spent the whole weekend thinking she'd suddenly reappear or she'd ring me. I couldn't believe what she'd done, Dad. But I accept it now. I mean, I realise she won't come back. Well, it's like a full stop and a new start, innit?
Yep.
I mean, I've got my own life, my own flat, and just got to get on with it.
Oh, don't waste any tears on her, darling. She's not worth it. You never know what she's like, because I've always protected you from her.
Dad?
Yeah?
Sharon about?
No.
Oh, supposed to be meeting her. She can't, but I can't find her anywhere.
She's upstairs with her dad.
Yeah, but I don't think he
wants to go up.
Duncan, you can't just stroll up there. What did you go and tell him for? Didn't want Sharon to himself tonight.
He can sort it out himself, love. It's got nothing to do with you or me.
The thing she's done to me, darling, the thing she's put me through. Do you know once she told me she was dying? She had cancer just to make me stay with her, and I believed her.
What? Sharon. Oh, sorry. I was looking for Sharon. Thought we were going out.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Well, as long as you're all right.
Yeah, she's fine.
See you tomorrow.
Yeah, I'll call, yeah. Well, come on then, about Mum.
What? Oh, forget it, darling. It's nothing. Something she said in an argument. She was drunk, probably. Or I'll rip the vic, eh?
I forgot, Dad. Sort of. Look, once you leave the vic, Dad, what are you gonna do, eh? I mean, I don't know where you're going or nothing, but now I've got this flat, you realise I can't come with you.
Well, I'm not going anywhere, darling.
What?
I'm staying here. I mean, all that stuff about finding a country pub has nothing to do with me. It's down the ranch. No, I'm staying here.
What about Pat and Frank? They'll go mad.
No, not here. I mean, I couldn't do that. The wine bar.
The wine bar?
Yeah, EastEnders. It's official this morning. I'm the new manager.
So you're not moving out of Walford after all?
No.
Oh, Dad. I'm so glad.
Hey! We open in half hour, you know. What's this? You notice?
No, yours. We took over in 4 weeks.
Oh, congratulations. Couldn't happen to a nicer couple.
Thank you.
So you're believing then?
Yeah, I'll be moving out in about 4 weeks.
Any idea where you're going?
Yes.
Got another pub?
Not exactly, no.
What then?
Wine bar. Henry's to be exact, and for the next 4 weeks I'll be extolling the virtues of the place. So if I was you two, I'd think of a way to hang on to your trade, because it'll take a bit more than real ale for that. And for the next 4 weeks, darling, you're still working for me, so it's bums off seats and fingers out of tills till then. It's very nice to see our local artists in here at lunchtime. It's the Queen Vic, the South Bank of Albert Square,
right? Yeah, well, I couldn't resist your beer, then.
Ah, that's where you're wrong, you see, because I didn't drink beer as a Vino Blanco. I mean, that's what stirred his creative juices. Maybe that's what you need. Have you thought about trying the wine bar at the end of Bridge Street?
What, to stir my creative juices? No, not recently.
Well done. Not for another 4 weeks at least.
Oh, I see. Bought it, haven't we?
Yes, then Watts is the new licensee.
Ah, well, I might give it a whirl, then.
Do that.
Right?
Yeah?
This is Scotch Bible, everyone.
Well, come around.
Is Ian Beanie?
I wouldn't know, mate. I only just got here. Donna, is Ian Beanie?
He was on the stall earlier.
We ain't there now. He's left Lady Falmouth in charge. Probably ain't took a pound note all morning.
That's typical of Ian, isn't it?
What?
Backing and leaving things.
Are you looking at
me? Oi, hold your horses, right? She's just making conversation. It's not her fault that Ian's rushed off and left the Brussels sprouts to fend for themselves. Now apologise.
He comes in here. You tell him he's dead. Here's
your
Chris.
Yeah, why not?
2 pints of it.
Ran in our sorrows, are we, gentlemen?
No, quite the opposite, Dad.
Oh, I thought you didn't have a driver.
Turned up, out the blue.
Oh, well, that's lucky, isn't it?
Oh, Doc Cotton.
Don't tell me she's driving for you now.
Oh, an old man.
Charlie Cotton? You said Charlie Cotton out with a lorry?
Yeah, what's wrong with it?
Nothing, gentlemen. You just keep drinking.
Why now? He should just about be driving into nowhere.
Just found out where Ian's been all day.
Where?
He's moved out.
What, at the flat?
Yeah, we're out. He's off, thank you.
Where is he now?
In the Vic. Just walked over and told me. Got out of there before blood, guessing.
Oh, I better go over and talk to him.
I don't know what you're worried about. He's left home before, hasn't he?
Yeah, this is different.
Oh, I don't see why.
Look, it wasn't for that, Donna. None of this would have happened.
Oh, don't start that again.
Look at this drone.
All right, I know. Look, I better go and find James.
Oh, James.
Yes, I want to get the evening off. I want to go and talk to Ian. Oh. While you're at it, you better read this. I don't want the accuser getting anything else from you.
What is it?
It's a letter from Donna's godmother. She wants me to meet Donna's parents. Well, you never know. I might be able to persuade him to talk some sense into her. James, look, can I ask a favour?
It's my lucky day.
Afraid not. Look, do you mind if I pack it in early tonight? Something's turned up.
Well, of course not. No, as if we're exactly busy.
Thanks. I'll get my coat.
Drink, Pete?
Hey, I'll put some posters up here. Henry's Wine Bar under new management.
You can't do that.
Why not? It's still my pub.
So where's that?
What's all this you don't tell us about you moving out?
Yeah, I've moved in with Barry.
But why?
Oh, well, I would have thought that was obvious. There's me having a relationship with my own sister and you say nothing. Some caring mother you turned out to be.
Oi, don't talk about your mum like that.
I'm 18, I talk to people how I like, thank you.
Not when I'm about you, don't.
Pete.
Come on, who do you think you are?
No, let's talk this out sensibly.
There's nothing to talk about.
Oh, there's nothing to talk about.
You're pathetic, you are, do you know that?
Oh, I'm pathetic. Well, I tell you this, darling. At least I know if I'm Martha or Blinky Martha.
Hey, just go and get a drink or something, will you? Go on. Den, can I talk to Ian round the back, if you don't mind?
Yeah, go on, do my best.
Ian, look, I know what you're thinking.
Oh, so what am I thinking?
Why didn't I tell you all sooner?
Yeah, well, it had crossed my mind, you know. It does seem the obvious thing to do, knock on the head of a relationship with my own sister.
Look, I thought it would all go away.
Yeah, but it didn't, though, did it?
No, I'm sorry. I was wrong. Look, I should have told you sooner.
Family heart to heart, is it, Mum?
Go away, Donna. This is between me and Ian.
Yeah, but I bet it concerns me, though. Look, Kathy, you're going to have to face this. I'm here to stay.
Can't you get it through your thick skull that I don't want you? I never did.
But you had me. I'm your daughter, and you have to face that.
I think I'll leave mother and daughter to fight it out. I'm off. See you.
Ian, please. Are you happy now?
No, but I will be.
Over my dead body.
Me? No, what? Well, then why are you looking at me that way?
What way?
I don't know. I just thought you were looking at me. Why would I want to do that?
Might have just been letting my eyes rest on that mangy bit of old wallpaper that's coming loose over there, that's all.
I'll get it.
Talk.
We ain't open yet.
Look, this is private.
I said we ain't open. Not for beers, wine, spirits, cheese and onion crisp and certainly not for teenage heartbreak chefs.
Just ignore her.
I better go before I do something rash. Talk quickly, we open in 10 minutes.
Well then.
Oh, is that all you got to say, is
no.
it? No. I suppose you thought it was funny, pretending you were trying to get off with me. Oh, silly little prat doesn't know I'm his sister. Let's set him up to knock him down, eh? How hilarious.
That is not what I thought.
Oh, so what did you think?
I don't know.
You don't know? You must know.
Look, I just wanted to get to know you.
Oh, and suppose I just jumped you one night?
Oh, come on, you wouldn't. You're too nice.
Too nice? Bit of a schmuck, am I, then?
No, but maybe you did sort of misunderstand. I mean, I just thought I was being friendly. I think you read too much into it.
Did I?
Yeah, you did. Look, Ian, all this hasn't been easy for me either, you know. I can't begin to tell you what I've been through. And there've been times when I felt like just ending it all, and that's the God's honest truth. You can't imagine what it's been like for me. I've been wondering all my life if there was anywhere in this world I belong. And then coming here and finding that my own mother doesn't even want to know me, doesn't want to try to get to know me or like me. I tell you, Ian, I've been through hell, and that's no lie.
Are you going to do any work here today at all, madam? Or are you going to stand there making a meal out of feeling sorry for yourself?
It's all right, she doesn't mean it.
You know that, Brad. Look, we've talked about it at least 20 times. I've agreed. So what are you getting so jumpy for at this stage of the game? Yes, I'm cautious too. You don't think I'd still be walking around today in one piece if I wasn't a bit cautious, do you?
Keep expecting those doors to swing open. Our Angie to stroll in, saying, guess what, didn't work out with love's middle-aged dream, and I'm back, so shove over, Pat.
Suppose anything's possible in this place.
It certainly is. How are you feeling now, Ian? Feel better?
Much better.
Dr. Legg say what he thought was up?
No, but I'm going to see him later.
Will you take care of yourself? Because take it from me, in this life nobody else will.
You're right, girl.
Hmm.
Oh, hi, Frank.
Colin. You asked him yet?
No, wait for the right moment.
Ask me what?
No, not you. Big white chief with the phone stuck permanently.
Hello,
yeah.
See you later.
Well, go on in, ask him.
No, you ask.
Ask me what?
We want a knife pack and have a week off.
Oh, you do you? What, just like that? Oh, I suppose now you think the weather's getting better, you can take your buckets and spades down the seaside, is that it?
How'd you know that? You've been here, Wiggin.
How else do you think I stay with one jump head?
It's just a week in Brighton, then there's a business management course that I want to attend to, plus the fact to give me and Pat a bit of a break.
And you're going to go whether I say yes or no?
Well, I think that...
Yes.
And what's this course for? To teach you how to get your own way? Well, I don't think there's much you can learn, darling. Do what you like, I don't care. I'm past caring about this place.
I mean, you're more afraid with local goings-on. Is Den part of the mob, or is Darren just indulging in one of his flights of fancy?
Well, put it this way. I don't think Darren's just suddenly gone doolally, if you see what I mean.
Kathy, do you mind if I ask you something? I can't help noticing you're a bit under the weather. Is something the matter?
Yeah, there is, as it goes.
Is there anything you'd like to talk about?
I don't know if I can.
Come on, a trouble shared's a trouble halved.
Trouble doubled, more like.
No, not always. Come on, why don't you tell me what's wrong?
Well,
it's something to do with Donna, isn't it?
Come on, so the old bush telegraph round is as good as it ever was.
So what's the matter?
Oh, Cathy, I was looking for you. Barry said you were here. Oh, dear, have I picked a bad moment? Story of my life.
Any time's a bad time, as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah, well, I won't hang about. I only came to say I'm sorry.
No, well, so am I. A lot of things got said that shouldn't have.
Well, if you ever do feel like talking, you know where to find me.
What's all that about?
I ate her. That's what it was about. God forgive me, I wish she was dead.
I don't understand.
No, I don't expect you would.
Well, I mean, I had heard rumours, and there was talk that she was your daughter.
Look, I'm sorry, but I don't really feel like talking now.
Well, fine, if you're going to be upset. What about a drink?
What do you reckon, then?
Yeah, it's fine. I can't see that there's much that needs doing to it, though.
So you don't reckon I need to bring the decorators in yet, then?
Yeah, eventually. It's right as it is. You could take over and run it without changing a thing.
It's the yuppies, darling. I've got to find out what sort of style they like.
What yuppies? I thought they'd gone bust again.
Don't you believe it. I wonder how your mother's getting on in Spain.
God, honestly, you two. The only time either of you ever gave a toss about one another was when the other one was missing. Just grow up.
All I said was, I wonder what your mother's...
Yeah, I know what you said, Dad. What I didn't like was the way you said it.
But Sally, darling, you're a sex object,
Dad,
isn't
please.
It? All right, I'm sorry.
Right, I'll see you later.
Yeah, ta-da.
Dennis, just a man.
Hurry up, I'm busy.
So about that matter we were discussing the other day.
Yes.
I've decided not to oppose the licence after all.
Oh, so you're not such a burp. Like I said, I'd hate to see you splattered all over the M25.
Yeah, so your business partners are a bunch of puds, then.
You know what's wrong with you? You've been watching too many black and white movies on the television.
Oh, let's try gangsters on for size, then, shall we?
Oh, has anyone told you you're the proverbial pain in the backside? You move into the square, you start telling the people who've lived here for years what they can and can't do. Now you're having a pop at my business partners.
Business partners? They're cutthroats and crooks.
Listen, Shorthouse, keep your mouth shut, right? Because you never know who's listening. You know what they say about careless talk costing lives? Now shut up and grow up before I really lose my temper.
Well, she's more or less given it the seal of her approval. Mind you, she hates anything these days unless it's got stained glass windows and heavenly choirs.
She's doing nothing about that bag of yeast, then?
I'm afraid so, mate.
It won't last.
Well, I thought she was just doing it to spite me and Ange, but it's been going on far too long with that. I've got a funny idea it's cool enough.
So I'm a tell, mate.
Yeah, well, if they do get hitched, I could always rope him in as assistant manager in the wine bar. Give it an air of respectability. Or better still, stick him in a dinner jacket and use him as a bouncer at weekends.
So what happened?
Oh, nothing. She looked at me like filth, so I said my bit and went.
She's probably embarrassed.
No, she hates me, I can tell.
Look, it's awkward for her. Donna, I know you can't be right. But I know what Mum's like, she don't hate anyone. Look, she's really easy going when you get to know her.
Yeah, well, it doesn't look like that's going to happen now, does it?
Any chance of getting a drink?
Yes.
Pat, here a minute.
I'm reading my horoscope.
Oh, forecast a trip to the seaside with Mr. Wright, does it?
No, it says, do not let workmates get on your nerves. They are behaving in an irrational, annoying manner, which may have nothing to do with you.
Just shows how wrong these astrologers could be then, doesn't it?
Well, what do you want?
Well, before you and Frank disappear to the coast with the knotted handkerchiefs tied on your head, there's a job I'd like you to do for me. Do a stock take at the freezer.
What?
You heard, I'm not getting love with paying for food I'm not going to sell now. Do it now, we're not busy. Here.
Now, I'll get it, Pat.
Oh, Johnny, come in, mate.
Have a word.
Trouble?
Yep.
Go on through.
Oh, my tumour.
Oh, it's all right, Pat.
The stocktaker's going to have a right game sorting this lot out.
Go and make a cup of tea, eh?
I don't fancy one, Tal.
Go upstairs, then.
I've got this lot to get up.
Just do it. Oh, that bad, is it?
Oh, down to yours truly and a few of these. All right?
Yeah, help yourself.
You know, you're different from this side of the jump.
What's happened?
Had a little tickle.
Look, you're going to tell me or do you want to see a proof?
I had a little tickle with Archie.
Archie?
Your motorman?
Ta-da, Johnny.
Yeah, it seems that way. Archie's being questioned.
Yeah, well, I don't want to slag you off,
yeah,
mate.
Well, listen, I know I want my brains tested, but you know what I'm like? I get a few of these down my neck and I trust you and my daughters on a desert island.
Oh, cheers.
Well, as I say, he's had his collar felt. Stands the reason he's going to scream like a stuck pig.
Yeah, I'll go along with that.
Well, it's only a matter of time before they give me a pull, and you know my chances are there.
Neil, since the last time you did a run out of Spain.
Yeah, well, I've come to a few, Bob. I've got it here. They're going to bang me up, remand me in custody, and drag it out for weeks.
Weeks?
Months, more likely. You know, Tommy Blake has been waiting 12 months to go up the steps. Needless to say, it wouldn't be in either of our interests to continue with the video business just now.
That's true. So you don't fancy having it on your toes, then?
No, not after the last time. I'd have done me bird by the time they brought me back. No, I'll have my day in court. Who knows?
Right, so what do you want me to do?
Well, you know my old lady. Stood the three-card trick for me.
Yeah, she's one of the millionaires, Ada, mate.
She's better than I deserve. You know something, Dan? They're the ones that do it, you know. The bird. It's all very well for the likes of me to get banged up. It's home from home for me. I know half the geezers in there anyway. Make a few deals. Even earn out of it. And that poor old cow at home. She's more in prison than I am. She's only got to pass the time of day with some bloke and some old busybody puts two and two together and makes five. Answer comes back to me. I do me nut and slag her off. She's doing her bird the hard way. She's got to bang herself up. I don't think I could do it. I know I couldn't do it. I expect it of her. I demand it.
You've got nothing to worry about with Ada, mate. She thinks the sun shines out of your ears.
Oh, Ada's a silly old cow, but I love her. She's going to be up to her eyes in debt by the end of the month, so I want you to feed her that. But slowly.
Yeah.
Sorry, I really am. I can't. Of course I like jazz. Who doesn't? Well, that's just it. I'm working. Well, maybe we could meet afterward.
Oh, cheer up. You're not here to bring cheers for the hunters, are you?
Women are so rude.
Yes, Doctor. Yes, Doctor. Are you with us, Doctor? Is there anything I can get you? Orange juice? Watch my lips, Doctor. Orange juice?
A large port.
I'll get it, Doctor. Large port.
Another world, isn't it?
It's the only one I've known since I took over this place.
Well, you're always welcome in here, then. That was just been.
Oh, you'll do.
Thanks, sir. Big step for me, this.
Well, I'd like to say you're among friends, but in this business, mate, it's dog eat dog.
It sounds normal, mate. I've got a few ideas.
And what are they? Because I've tried them all. There's only one bit of advice I'm going to give you. It's that treat your customers fair. They're so used to being stitched up round here, you give them extra half inch of beer, they think you're God's gift. Stand your regulars a drink, the right ones, but above all, be the governor. And that's the only bit of advice you're going to get from me, because in 3 weeks' time, when I leave this place to take over the wine bar, I'm going to nick all your customers.
Tell me something I never know about.
All right, then. Have a word.
be the governor, eh?
You've got a lot to learn, pal.
I'm a bit too long in the tooth to learn new tricks, but if I was you, cocker, I'd give that heap of trash bunches of that.
Well, maybe you should have stayed in the car business.
We had our parasites in our world, don't worry about that, but I never met one that could stand up on a tile either.
Drink?
So how's the laundry business?
Bit of a struggle.
Struggles will be over when you're moving the wine bar, we'll knock it on the head, then.
I'm pleased to hear it. Now, I've had some thoughts about the wine bar.
It's Frank.
Yeah.
Do you reckon he'll do business with us?
How would I know? Like I said, I've had some thoughts about the wine bar.
Don't worry yourself, Dan. It's all in hand. You're sorting out the staff and the decorating.
Yeah, the staff. I'd like some say in that. I mean, I've been in this business a long time.
So have we.
Well, it should be a good earner then, shouldn't it?
I hope so. We put a lot of money into it.
It'll take a while to get established.
We'll see.
Oh, so we're not talking long-term investment, then? Is there any danger you let me in on what's happening?
I don't know myself, mate, what they're up to. I'm not you, then. Just a lackey, which you're very highly thought of.
Oh, yeah, an upper-class lackey rather
than... You want to get your facts straight, Danny, boy, you wouldn't even have this booze and have if you didn't have friends. Remember, you squared your debts up.
And if I remember rightly, I risked my collar for it.
Well, that's the advantage of belonging to the club, isn't it? Something goes wrong, you and yours get taken well care of. Of course, that cuts both ways. Cheer up, then. You're going to earn a good living and you'll be your own boss. Well, as much as any of us are. See you later. So you're taking over, eh?
That's right.
Wish you the best of luck. Get a large scotch, darling. You never know. We might be able to put a bit of business your way.
No, I don't think so, pal.
Can I take?
We'll see. For you.
Oh, sorry.
Donna. I insist.
Your money.
Well, I've got to hand it to you. Certainly didn't start off on the right foot there.
Oi! What am I inheriting here?
On the other side of the jump.
Listen to me. When you go, you take your dirty washing with it. They may flatten you, pal, but they don't flatten me.
As someone that's supposed to have been around a bit, you certainly act stupid. Now, never, but never mouth off to me again and certainly never lay your hands on me, do you understand?
You.
Frank!
Yo! Brad, ain't it? You don't know me, but I thought we could do each other a favour.
What favours could you do me?
Well, I'm a bit of a versatile bloke. Bit of ducking and diving. Come whatever should the need arise.
Not me.
For instance, the governor of the Dagmar's been mouthing off. They could be a problem to you. Nothing like having someone local to take care of your interests on the manor now, is it? Yeah, ask around about me. I'm known. I can be useful.
Then make yourself useful. Clean the windscreen.
What about?
That's all right, I'm not so busy.
I'm not too busy. It's about me and Kath, isn't it?
Look, I promised Kath I wouldn't talk to you.
Yeah, well, she wouldn't want you to talk to me, would she?
But this is causing Kath a lot of anger.
I told you before, I am not leaving Milford.
No, I just mean, can't you forget
you
that?
You want me to forget that she's my mother?
Well, she's not really, is she? Well, I mean, she is,
yes,
but...
Yes, she is. Why does she hate me so much?
Kathy don't hate you. Kathy couldn't hate anybody. She's a good woman.
Well, you would think that anyway.
Now, don't try slagging her off to me.
I'm not trying to slag her off. Why would I want to slag her off? I just want her to love me. Look, why can't she meet me halfway? It must have been awful for her when she had me, but that wasn't my fault. And all right, so she has no maternal feelings for me. But does that mean we can't be friends? Why do I have to feel guilty about being born?
Oh, no, it's not like that. You don't know Kathy.
Oh, do you?
What are you talking about,
oh,
do
nothing.
I?
Nothing.
Wait, what do you mean?
Look, it's not for me to say, Pete.
Say? Say what? Now, look, maybe me and Kath don't get on all the time, but...
It's not fair what she's doing to me, and it is not fair what she's doing to you.
To me?
Oh, look, I'm sorry. I don't want to cause any more trouble.
Hang on, what she's doing to me?
No, forget it, Pete. I've said too much.
See, why'd you have, darling? Said too much to stop now, so out with it.
No, no, this customer's 1-7.
You stay out of this, Pat. And you were saying?
See, I'm in trouble here now, and it's all because of her.
One of these printing days.
Secret, Pete. If you had half an eye, you'd see Wilmot Brown is all over Kathy, and she isn't exactly pushing him away. It makes you think, doesn't it? Maybe she took my natural father for a ride, too.
There you go, mate.
Oh, cheers, Dan. Hey, I'll be all right for the salad order when you take over the wine bar, won't I? Can't see Pat doing many favours.
Yeah, sure, why not?
I mean, I've got to look after my regulars. Here, there's one favour you could do me, Dan.
Yeah, go on, feel free.
No, it's about Kath.
Look, if it's heart to heart about personal relationships, forget it. No offence, but I've got some real problems of my own, mate.
No, I want you to give her a job.
But she's got a job. She's got two jobs.
Yeah, but one about the Dagmar. Been nothing but egg roll between the two of us since she's been there. Now, you offer a job in the wine bar, she'll probably go for that. Long as you don't find out I suggested it.
Listen, I've not even started it yet, mate, and you're picking a star for me?
Oh, come on, Ben, you know she's good behind the bar. Think about it.
Well, I'll have to ask me lord and masters. They're the ones who have the final say.
Ah, well done, Ben. I'll tell her now.
Hang about, Pete. I'll never...
posted your letter. I caught Whitsy with that dirty little tart from the hat store.
So?
Not that she's any threat, but that's not the point. He lied to me.
Oh, a bit like the pot calling the kettle black,
isn't it? It's not funny. Nothing matters to you, does it?
No. Now get some work done and try and force a smile. I don't want my customers crying in their beer. It's watered down enough already.
No, that's all anybody ever says to me. I do her life besides being the ex-living lover of the recently departed Mary Smith.
It's just a polite question. I don't know why I even asked. Never liked the girl when she did live here. You still squatting in her flat?
Yeah.
You don't want someone to help meet the rent, do you? I could pretend to be Mary up the council office, couldn't I?
No.
Oh, end of a stimulating conversation.
Sorry, I'm just a bit edgy today.
Yeah, well, so am I. I'm paid to be nice. Hunters, so that's why I'm being nice, all right?
Can't say I'd noticed.
Well, thank you very much. So why are you feeling edgy, then?
I don't know. I woke up with this terrible urge to go and see me mum and dad, and the only thing to do is get smashed till it passes off.
Don't you get on with them?
Oh, me dad's all right. Mm. End of conversation number three. Your turn.
No, I got customers to serve, thank goodness.
No, go on. What's your problem?
Oh, it's Wixie.
Boring, boring.
You know that dirty little scrubber that works at the hat store? She wears dreadful clothes.
Cindy, you mean?
Yeah, stupid name and all, innit? Do you find her attractive?
Well, let's just say I was thinking of leaving my body to medical research, but now I reckon I might let her have a crack at it first.
There you go. None of you's got any taste whatever.
When you get round to it, I'll have a double scotch. I've been waiting ages.
Have you now? That's a pity, isn't it?
I ain't got a drink in this flea pit, you know.
That's true. You know where the door is.
Oh, what's eating you?
Nothing. I've just been having a chat with a pal of mine.
Who?
Brad.
Son?
He tells me you've been cheeky in places you shouldn't have been cheeky in. A small fry like you shouldn't play with the big boys. Now, if I was you, I'd have to keep my head down, I'd better still get out of town.
Can I leave the place?
Are you sure it's all right to park?
You must be Mr. and Mrs. Ludlow from Cathyville.
How do you do?
Hello. Pleased to meet you.
It was a longer journey than we thought. I'm sorry we kept you waiting. Gerald works locally in Bromley and I don't get up to town much, so we got a bit lost.
We did nothing of the sort, Jackson. I had the route all mapped out. It was just the sheer volume of traffic and all those one-way systems.
Mrs. Beale doesn't want to know all that.
Well, we're not going to make small talk, are we? But thank you for coming. Look, I'm sorry to land you with this, but I was desperate.
It was the least we could do. When my friend June, Donna's godmother, came to see you, she eventually told me about it, in confidence. And I was so relieved that you made the decision you did. I couldn't see that any good could come from Donna getting in contact with you. Not that we've ever been able to stop Donna doing anything she wanted to once she'd made up her mind.
No, I found that out to my cost. Look, Mrs. Watkins promised me that that would be the end of it. So much for promises.
Please believe me, we knew nothing about it until you wrote to us. It came as a terrible shock. Isn't that right, Gerald?
It's been a very upsetting time for all of us. Donna just gets carried away with whatever ideas she's got in her head. She's always been an emotional, imaginative girl, leaping into things.
Regardless of other people's feelings. Look, I'm sorry if I seem angry, but it's no use pretending. I am.
Well, we only knew what she tells us when she comes home.
She's always been somewhat economical with the truth.
Oh, don't beat about the bush. She tells lies. I'm a mother and I can say it if no one else can. Right from being a child. I don't know why. I dare say it's our fault, but some of the things she used to tell her teachers at school about our lives. She said I was dying of an incurable disease.
Oh, young girls do that to some extent. It's a sign of insecurity.
Don't defend her like you always do. She had nothing to be insecure about. We always gave her what she wanted. Maybe that was the problem. She's always been trouble. I love her, but that's true.
It only started when she found out she was adopted. If we'd taken her to a therapist, as they suggested...
She'd have told lies there, too. Gerald, it isn't doing any good washing our dirty linen in public. The point is, what are we going to do about all this now?
Well, you've got to do something. I mean, you've no idea what this is doing to my life, to my family. She's a part of my past that I don't want to be reminded of. I made that quite clear to Mrs. Watkins. I meant it then, and I mean it now.
She's a grown woman.
We can try.
Just what has she told you about her life, Randy?
Only that she's working in a solicitor's office, making use of her own levels, and doing quite well. She liked it, and she'd made friends.
She wouldn't let us visit the bedsit she's living in, and we thought it best at the time to let her get on with it.
Well, that's another pack of lies. I mean, it's news to us, Randy, that she's qualified to anything apart from stirring up trouble.
What do you mean?
Donna is working as a barmaid at the Queen Vic on the corner of the square.
Barmaid? That's ridiculous. Why would you want to do a job like that?
Well, I suggest you find her and ask her yourselves. Perhaps it'll make her see reality. Look, I'm sorry if I seem so hard, but I'm desperate. You've got to try and convince her, I mean it. Make her come back home, leave him, move away, anything. Just as long as she leaves me and my family alone.
You get a drink in here.
Do you think he's had enough from one lunchtime?
He's not drunk anyway. We're here to sell the stuff, not act as part-time counsellors for Alcoholics Anonymous.
Haven't you got anything better to do than sitting here lunchtimes? I thought you were supposed to be minding Barry's stall.
That's what I like about you, you know, your charm. I suppose I could always go and see my dad at work, make him promise not to tell me mum where I am.
So? What's so terrible? Why don't you go home?
You must be joking. While she was on the road, it's a perfect excuse there. Just drop her a postcode once a month, keep her happy.
Pretend you are. She's not to know, is she?
There's a fool. You're not as daft as you look, are you? I could get a mate to send him from all over the country.
You know, you're lucky. I don't have that problem. My parents don't care where I am or what I do.
Hello, Donna. We were told you were working here.
We know you must be busy, love, but we thought, as we were in the area, you know...
We'll meet you in the cafe over the road after you finish work. About 3:30, all right?
Well, I told you just what we said. Well, I felt really sorry for her, especially her. I mean, she must feel awful about it. They're quite nice people, really. Not the sort I imagined. I did feel I was a bit hard on them, but, I mean, there's no other way, is there? She's been telling all sorts of stories about what she's been up to. I just don't understand why she wants to behave like it.
Look, Kat, come on. Don't weaken now. Go home, make yourself a nice cup of tea, eh?
No. I better go round and see your mum first. Make some peace between her and Pauline. Going like a killing. Why does he want to go and live there for when he's got a perfectly good room at home?
Cap, I don't understand teenage kids anymore. But look on the bright side, eh? There's something to be said for us being on our own. We have to pay the poll tax for stuff.
Yeah, I suppose so. I will have to pay Paul and Bruce Keep anyway. I mean, they need the money. That's if he ends up there, and I reckon he will.
Fair enough, long as that boy stays at college. And by the way, I think I'll pick you up after you finish working the deck tonight.
What for?
Well, I thought we might pop up the club for now.
I'm going to be done in by that time.
Well, I can walk you home, can't I? And I should do it more often. I should be walking across that estate in the dark.
Yeah, it's looking really well.
Yeah, well, Sharon does most of the work. I ain't really got time.
Well, if there's anything needs fixing, don't forget to ask.
Yeah, I think I can manage that. Do you mind if I get back to typing? I've got a hell of a lot to do for Dr. Legg.
Yeah, it's good you're working for him. It's easier for Vicky too. You're getting yourself together, then?
Yeah, I think I am. Look, if you want a cup of coffee, you'll have to make it yourself.
No, that's all right. I just popped over to see how you girls are getting on.
You're really growing up lovely, aren't you, darling, eh?
Then don't get her excited, will you? I'm trying to get her into a routine before she starts nursery. I can't expect Sharon to carry on as unpaid babysitter.
Yeah, well, you're doing too much of that calf. You're looking worn out.
I've got no choice, you know that, then.
Yeah, anyway, it's a birthday present for Vicky.
What is it?
Premium bond vouchers. You can't argue with that. If you come up on early, all your money problems will be sold at once. Now stick it in your pocket.
Thanks, then. Can't really afford to turn down money in any form.
Oh, just passing. Didn't realise you had company.
No, that's all right. I was just going. Just popped in to see how the girls were. Don't forget, if anything needs fixing, I'll have a word with McIntyre, right? Yeah. I'll pop and see Sharon later on. Come here, Riley.
Riley, come
on. Ah, just about the one to see. Your parents is waiting for you over in the cafe. Oh, and they're a lovely couple. They was looking a bit lost, so I got into conversation with them. And they're a nice surprise.
What have you been telling them about me?
There's no need to take that tone with me, young lady. I was just performing a neighbourly gesture.
Oh, what's this, Dot? After hours drinking?
Excuse me, I don't want to rush you or anything, but I've got to close the cafe for an hour or two. Honestly. Hello?
How did you know I was here? You must have been following me.
Look, yes. Sit down, Mrs. Beale got in touch with us and asked us to meet her.
We know all about that, so it's no use you pretending otherwise. You had no right to do that to her. She let it be known a long while ago that she didn't want to know you, and you should have respected that decision.
Why couldn't you come to us and talk about it? We've always been open with you.
I didn't want to hurt your feelings.
Do you think I don't know what it's like for you? Of course you'd want to see what she was like. But to go on with it when you could see you weren't wanted...
That's not true. I'm starting to feel like I belong here.
That isn't the way she put it.
Come on, love. We want you there. We promise we'll never mention it again.
Dad, I'm 22 years old. I'm very grateful for all that you've done for me, but it's my life now, and this is where I want to be. I've got myself a place to live. I've got myself a job. I know it's not the job you wanted for me, but it's a job.
I'm trying to understand, but after all your education, why would you want to work as a barmaid in a place like that?
Because I like it. The atmosphere's warm and friendly. I meet all sorts of people, and they just accept me for what I am without passing judgment on me.
You're fooling yourself there. From what Mrs. Cotton's been saying, the people around here are very curious about what you're up to and why you've been telling them all these garbled stories about your life.
I don't want to listen to her because she's just a wicked old gossip.
She was very charitable about you. She put it down to your youth. But you're not that young anymore, and it's no excuse.
I knew you'd be like this if I told you what I was really doing. You don't care about me at all.
We care about you very much. Otherwise, we wouldn't have bothered to come here.
I didn't ask you to.
We just want you to be happy and to use your talents.
No, you don't. You just want me to have a nice, safe job and a nice, safe marriage like yours. But that's not what I want. You don't know what I'm like at all. No, I don't care of people here, because people around here say what they feel. It's not like the suburban rubbish that you brought me up with, where people pretend all the time.
Well, you're the one who's doing the pretending. You're just being romantic about a world you don't belong in. We gave you a good education, Donna.
So? I passed a few exams. It's nothing to do with what I really am.
Donna, listen to me. When you get bored with this, and you will, because you're looking for a sort of belonging that doesn't exist, you can walk away from it into a well-paid job. The people you want so much to be a part of don't have that.
I'm a part of Kathy. I don't care what she's told you. She's my mother, and nothing you can say can take that away from me. Hello.
All right? Gran feeling better?
Well, she's gone to bed. She don't want to discuss it.
Oh, it's all right then.
No, it's not all right, Ian. Paul and Arthur don't want you here, and I don't blame them. They deserve a bit of peace.
I don't know what you're getting at me for. It weren't my idea, it was Gran's. What would you rather do? Go live in a squat? You'd have something to say about that, wouldn't you?
But there's no need for any of this. If you got chucked out of Dr. Legs, it's your own fault, but you're not homeless. Me and your dad didn't want you to leave. How about if we made your room more into like a bedsit? You know, you could have a kettle in there and that, and we wouldn't come in unless you asked us to.
A bedsit? That room's just about big enough for a bed and a cupboard. Oh, we've been through all this before.
But we never interfered with
you. I just want me independence.
But you're still a student. There's plenty of time for all that when you've passed your exams and you've got a bit of money behind you. We won't get much freedom here anyway. You know what your gran's like. She'll want to know what you're doing and who you're doing it with.
I haven't made my mind up yet. I might find somewhere else.
And you won't be able to fetch any girls home. I can tell you that now.
Oh, I should be so lucky.
Ian, will you just let me know something? Was it all the trouble that we've been having home lately that's made you want to leave? Because if it was, I'd rather you told me.
I don't know what all the fuss is about. I'm going.
We handled it all wrong, you know. Said all the wrong things.
Leave her be. It's what she wants.
She didn't mean to hurt us like that.
Do you think I don't know that? I know her inside out. In spite of all that, I'm still her mother. At least she's not on drugs or living with some awful boy like the Robinsons girl.
Yes, that's right. And she's not adopted. Perhaps we make too much of that. Maybe it's just daughters growing up.
We'll leave it a while and then write to her. Let her know that whatever happens, we'll always be there.
I thought I saw you coming in. How did it go?
I'm sorry, Mrs. Bean. We did what we could. She didn't want to know, I'm afraid.
Donna.
Oh, I thought you were out all day.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Look, I know you're tired, but can't you come round tonight? I really need to talk to you, and I mean, you don't have to do anything special. Just be quiet.
I told you. We'll do it some other time when we've both got a bit more energy, all right? I'll give you a ring.